Thank you for joining me today. My name is Natasha Crespo, and I'm your Reference and Digital Access Librarian here at PNW. Today, we're going to be going over one of my favorite research resources here. You're going to find it on the library homepage. So let's go ahead and get started by opening up an internet browser. We prefer that you use Google Chrome, Firefox, or Safari when accessing library resources. If you've never been to our website, you can reach us from any PNW webpage. You're going to find a link to the library on the top. Once you get to our page, you're going to see a plethora of wonderful resources. Today, we're going to focus on that EBSCO search, which is under the Find section. If you go ahead and click on that, when you are on campus, it'll bring you straight to the database. If you're at home, you will need to put in your PNW username and password, and this is only available to current students, staff, and faculty. Okay, we're going to go ahead and click on Advanced Search. I always like to have more than one search box, but that's because I like to have more in life. All right, and today we were actually doing a search on Shakespeare. So let's go ahead and put in some Shakespeare. We're going to look for The Tempest. Okay, and you can see that it's already giving us suggestions on things that we might want to search. If you weren't sure where to get started, you may want to try selecting one of these. We're going to just try The Tempest, and then I'm going to put Shakespeare here. Okay, we're going to go ahead and click Search. Now, if you look at that, just putting in Tempest and Shakespeare, I have 3,502 results. That's too many for me, and I need to start narrowing it down. There are a lot of wonderful limiters that are going to make it easier to do that. So depending on the kind of resource you need, you can actually limit it by type. If I wanted to look at what's going on in the news, maybe book or play reviews, or even magazines, I could check these boxes to see those. If I wanted to focus on academic journals, which in a college environment you typically want to look at those more often, I could check those as well. So I'm just gonna focus on those, right? And our results have gone down to 1,308. That's a big jump. It's cut down by a third. I'm getting closer to finding what I was looking for. Another option, I can click on scholarly peer-reviewed journals. If you need scholarly research or academic sources, that's typically what people are talking about. These would also be referred sources. The database is picking that out for us, so we don't have to actually check every single journal to make sure they meet the requirements of peer review. It's already been done for us. Yay, technology! From there, we can even cut it down by date. It says 1902 because this resource actually goes all the way back to 1902. So I might just look at what's been happening in the last 5 years. All right, and just limiting it down to there, I'm down to 229 results. Now, if I wanted to see the articles that are only available in this database, I would actually need to use another limiter, because right now we have resources we would need to see if the library has somewhere else, and we have resources that we could view in our browser right now. I'm going to go ahead and check full text. And then I'm down to 92, and I am looking at just what this database has to offer. I'm being given various titles of the articles to try and pick one I want to read. If you like that first one, you've clicked on it, you like the abstract, and you like what you've seen here, you can go ahead and click that email button. It's going to email you a PDF of this article. And whether you're at home or on campus, you can download it, read it, store it, put it in the cloud, keep it forever. You would just put in your email address, and then if you'd like, a subject. If you prefer it to be sent as plain text, you can as well. And then you can even decide to have it provide you a citation format. So if you're using APA, Chicago style, or MLA, you can have it try to give you that information right away. Another great tool of this database is the Cite button. You should always be citing any research you use. And when you click Cite, it gives you the format of the work cite, of the citation for the Works Cited page in a variety of styles. this will make your citation page easier, but always make sure you double check afterwards to see that everything formatted correctly and you make sure you're following proper style. For more information, please contact OIT or the library, and I can't wait to join you guys again.